بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا محمد خاتم الأنبياء والمرسلين. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبع هداه بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. Dear brothers, the topic of Islam and Christianity is not just important. It is essential because the fact that we are living in a Christian society and where the kids are exposed to a lot of attack from the media, from the school, from their classmates, and we can see that how much money and effort and you know, papers, magazines are talking about Christianity. But unfortunately, they never talked about Christianity. They talk about just one issue, just to make the people emotional and either for them to donate. And I don't know exactly what's the goal, because anybody who is doing some work for the cause of Allah, he has to do it honestly. And he has to be genuine. Every time I hear those evangelists talking about Christianity, I never heard any about Christianity. They don't talk about the Bible. They don't talk about Prophet Isa. But they talk about certain issue, just believe in Jesus. Jesus is a savior. And if you don't believe in Jesus, then you are lost, you go to hell. If you believe in Jesus, that everything is fine, no matter what you do. And none of these is included in the Christianity. None of what they teach has anything to do with the Christianity. The real Christianity is the religion of Tawheed. It is the religion that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent through Prophet Isa to make the people more kind, more compassionate, have more khushu', more fear to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this is basically the reason or the cause that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent Isa alayhi salam. Because the distance between Isa and Musa is so wide, about 1500 years. 1500 years with the children of Israel is so long, because they change right away and they change their mind, they change their books. They have the tendency to disobey. They did that with even their own prophet, with Musa alayhi salam. And there are so many other prophets has been killed by the children of Israel. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent Isa because the tawheed that came in the Judaism, and let me say tawheed, not the exact meaning that we mean in Islam. Tawheed in Islam means tawheed is that. Is that which means Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala himself is one. Tawheed al-Sifat, that there is no equal to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in any of his aspects. There's nobody can be Rahim like Allah. There's nobody can be powerful like Allah. There's nobody who can aziz like Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is unique in each and every aspect that he taught us. And wahdaniyah has to include that part. Tawheed al-Sifat. We cannot associate any human being or anything with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in any of his sifat. So if you think that anybody cause risk besides Allah, it is a shirk. Although you believe that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is wahid, ahad, fardun, samad, if you think somebody can cause harm or profit besides Allah, this is shirk. If you believe that anybody has the same power like Allah, it's a shirk. So the tawheed of the Judaism has failed that part. They know, acknowledge Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is only one. There is no partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But when they came to the sifat, this is where they failed. They think that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is, he can get angry, he can cry, he can feel sad. And this is, wal'ayazu billah, kufr. It is not, has nothing to do with tawheed. And this is where their tawheed failed. And also, the last thing in tawheed in Islam is tawheed al-asma. What's the difference between asma and the sifat? It's almost the same. But there is asma, there is some sifat, it's not in the asma illa al-husna. Like say, in the ayah, Allahu nuru samawati wal ard. There's no, the 99 names of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't include al-nur. But this is sifa, and this is adjective or an aspect of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So tawheed al-zat wa-sifat wa-al-asma is what makes Islam unique. And what makes Islam is the only religion that believe Allah, in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala the proper way. So, Judaism by the time has been distorted, and also as Christianity has added and subtracted from their Bibles, and they even put something that never been there on the Bibles. Also, the Judaism has the same problems also. Because if we, inshallah, in another lecture, we're going to talk about the history of Judaism and Christianity. And both religions, especially the Christianity, has suffered a lot of injustice. I'm talking about the early Christian, the tyrant dictators of the Roman Empire at the time, especially the four emperors, until the year 380. They suffered a lot of oppression, and people used to be killed if they are muwahideen. Why? Because the theme of that era was Trinity. Philosophy was based in Trinity. The philosophers, they said there is a God. They don't deny that. But it can't be one. There is a God for good, God for bad, and a God in between. So he make peace in case of argument happen with the other two gods. The Buddhist and Krishna, which is the old Indian religions, it is based also in Trinity, which is Taslis, three gods at the same time. The Egyptian religion, the old Egyptian religion, had the same thing. So Christianity was the religion of Tawheed, the oneness of Allah. This is what Isa brought from heaven. This is what was revealed to him by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the pure Tawheed. So pure Tawheed for a few against Trinity of the majority, it doesn't match. So they've been suffered all kinds of punishment, and maybe I'm not 100% sure, but as I read in some of the tafsir, قتل أصحاب الأخدود النار ذات الوقود إذ هم عليها قعود وهم على ما يفعلون بالمؤمنين شهود. It came for those early Muslims that followed Sayyidina Isa. We say Muslims because they are Muslims. And this is what Allah, the Quran says. When Sayyidina Isa said, من أنصار إلى الله؟ سورة الصف. قال الحواريون نحن أنصار الله. آمنا به واشهد بأننا مسلمون. واشهد بأننا مسلمون. Because the Islam is a submission to the will of Allah. Submission to the rules of Allah. the absolute obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is what Islam is. And that was the religion of all the prophets since Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created this universe. Islam is the religion, and this is the only religion. Before I go to the Bibles and what they said about Isa alayhi salam, and what Isa said about himself and about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is the topic of today, I would like to read some ayats about what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about Isa. Why? Because we as Muslims, no matter what anybody says, our reference is not to check the Bibles or check here or check there. Our reference is the Holy Quran. And the Holy Quran to us is yaqeen. Yaqeen, which we have no doubt in any way, at any circumstances. Alif, lam, mim. ذلك الكتاب لا ريب. There's no doubt. لا ريب فيه هدى المتقين. الذين يؤمنون بالغيب ويقومون الصلاة ومما رزقناهم ينفقون والذين يؤمنون بما أنزل إليك وما أنزل من قبلك وبالآخرة هم يوقنون. We are the people of yaqeen. Whatever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the whole Quran is yaqeen for us. We don't have to hear anybody. We don't have to debate anybody. But for the fact that if you'd like to introduce Islam to a non-Muslim, especially the majority in this country are Christian, first of all, Jews, they don't make da'wah. They think they are better than anybody. They think they are the chosen people. They are the children of Israel, and they are better than anybody else. So they don't make da'wah. So there's no harm for that point. And also, a Jew is the one who was born from a Jewish mother. A Jewish father is not enough to make the son a Jew. It has to be a Jewish mother. So for that, there is no harm that come to any religion from people convert to Judaism. And those who convert, I believe that they just convert voluntarily for one reason or another. So what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about Isa in the whole Quran, because we have to state that fact, that this is the rules. And then we'll discuss what the Christian has claimed about Isa. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Surah Al-Baqarah, Ayah 116, said, وَقَالُوا اتَّخَذَ اللَّهُ وَلَدًا سُبْحَانَهُ بَلْ لَهُ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ كُلٌّ لَهُ قَانِتُونَ. They said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has taken a son, subhanahu. تعالى الله عما يقولون علوا كبيرا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala واحد أحد فرد صمد. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has no equal, no partner, no son, no brother, no relatives. He is different than what anything that touch your mind. And whatever you think, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is greater than that. He doesn't eat, he doesn't sleep. لا تأخذه سنة ولا نوم. He doesn't need to rest. As Jews said that he worked for 6 days and he has to rest on the Sabbath, which is Saturday. It's all kufr with the aspect of Allah. Again, to the main tawheed, it's kufr. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to think that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because he worked 6 days, he got tired and he has to rest. No. And the whole Quran said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created the universe in 6 days. But never in the whole Quran mentioned that that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala need to rest or to take a nap or felt sad or anything like that. Subhanahu wa ta'ala amma yaqulun 'aluwan kabira. وقالوا اتخذ الله ولدا سبحانه له ما في السماوات والأرض كل له قانتون بديع السماوات والأرض وإذا قضى أمرا فإنما يقول له كن فيكون. سبحانه وتعالى he is the one who invented, created, started this universe. بديع السماوات والأرض وإذا قضى أمرا and when he سبحانه وتعالى decide a matter he just say كن فيكون. He said be and is going to be. There is nobody can resist the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even the very close angels. They are just to listen and to obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in any order that He issues subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given in the whole Quran all the acquisitions or the denial or the fallacies the Christian or the Jews had put in their books. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he didn't study the history. He does not know anything about history. He didn't read. He does know how to read. His society was the society of the mushriks of Mecca. And then he went to Medina. There were some Jews. So he might know something about the Jews by the fact that there was neighbors and sharing the residency in the Medina. But to know all the details about Christianity and what the Christian has done and what they said, what they invented, the Prophet ﷺ didn't have any source of knowledge except the Wahy. Whatever came to him through the Wahy, that was his only knowledge. It was the knowledge that came from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Few ayats also about Isa alayhi salam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said on Surah An-Nisa, A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. يا أيها الناس قد جاءكم الرسول بالحق من ربكم فآمنوا خير لكم وإن تكفروا فإن لله ما في السماوات والأرض وكان الله عليما حكيما. A fact, a command, an order from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يا أيها الناس, all mankind, everybody, قد جاءكم الرسول بالحق. The prophet has came to you the truth. فَآمِنُوا خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ. And when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said الرسول, it's a definition, alif al-lam for the definition. الرسول means Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He came to you with the truth. So believe is better for you. Take the right choice. Don't, you know, fight the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَآمِنُوا خَيْرًا لَكُمْ وَإِن تَكْفُرُوا. If you choose the kufr, فَإِنَّ لِلَّهِ مَا فِي السَّمَاوَاتِ وَمَا فِي الْأَرْضِ وَكَانَ اللَّهُ عَلِيمًا حَكِيمًا. Everything in this universe belongs to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You will never, whether one or group or a nation or a sect, decrees anything from the kingdom of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala specified the speech from يَا أَيُّهَا النَّاسِ to يَا أَهْلِ الْكِتَابِ. The next ayah. يا أهل الكتاب لا تغلوا في دينكم. Do not exaggerate. Do not exaggerate. Don't say something that is not truth. يا أهل الكتاب لا تغلوا في دينكم ولا تقولوا على الله إلا الحق. Do not exaggerate and don't say anything to describe Allah سبحانه وتعالى with falses. لا تقولوا إلا الحق. Don't say anything but the truth. Don't build a religion based on false and challenge Allah سبحانه وتعالى in his universe. This is the worst thing a human being can do. إنما المسيح عيسى بن مريم رسول الله. المسيح عيسى بن مريم, the Messiah, the son of Virgin Mary, رسول الله. He is an apostle of Allah. He is رسول الله. He is نبي. He is a prophet. Nothing more than that. إنما المسيح عيسى بن مريم رسول الله وكلمته ألقاها إلى مريم وروح منه. فآمنوا بالله ورسله ولا تقولوا ثلاثة انتهوا خيرا لكم إنما الله إله واحد سبحانه أن يكون له ولد له ما في السماوات والأرض وكفى بالله وكيلا. We're going to stop in this ayah for a couple of minutes because it has a couple of issues that we have discussed in detail, that Masih is Rasul. This is the end of the story. He is nothing more than Rasul, a human being that was selected to carry a message, to deliver the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not only that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنَّمَا الْمَسِيحُ عِيسَى بْنُ مَرْيَمَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ وَكَلِمَتَهُ. A brother who was reverted to Islam, he was like new Muslim. He asked me, why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about Isa that Isa is kalimatullah and rawhullah, and this is something close to what the Christian said. So I told him, subhanallah, let us sit down for 5 minutes, I explain the ayah to you. Kalimatullah, the Mufassirin said, the kalima of kun, be. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said be, and it's going to be. And this is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when Jibreel came to Virgin Mary, and she was scared. She never seen a man before. All her life is serving in the temple. And she got shaked and she's so scared. إني أعوذ بالرحمن منك إن كنت تقيا. And she, I seek refuge by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Unless you are taqi, unless you have taqwa. قال إنما أنا رسول ربك لأهب لك غلاما زكيا. I am the prophet of, I am a messenger from Allah to give you a child. A pure child. غلاما زكيا. زكيا from زكاة. طاهر. Pure. قالت أن يكون لي غلام ولم يمسسني بشر ولم أكو بغية. How come I will have a child and I never been touched by a man and I never been of bad manners. بغية, which is the prostitute. I never commit zina or something to displease Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. قال إنما أنا رسول ربك لأهل بلك غلاما زكية. قالت أن يكون لي غلام ولم يمسسني بشر ولم أكو بغية. قال كذلك قال ربك. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said. It's done deal. There is no argument. This is a decision by Allah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said كن فيكون. And it is all over. So this is the meaning of كلمته. The كلمة كن. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said is going to be a child, you know, by a virgin. It is done. How about وَرَوْحٌ مِنْهُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created the souls before the bodies. Each one of us, before he's born, before we are born, the soul is already there. When we are being delivered, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brings the soul to that body. وَيَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ الرُّوحِ قُلِ الرُّوحُ مِنْ أَمْرِ رَبِّي. So a ruh is something only Allah knows about it. Only Allah knows what ruh is going to go to which body. And only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows when this ruh will get out of the human being. And what is the ruh? Basically, all the ulama started to talk about it. Nobody knows the secret about a ruh except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَيَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ الرُّوحِ قُلِ الرُّوحُ مِنْ أَمْرَ رَبِّي. وَاللَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى in this ayah said وَرُوحٌ مِنْهُ. It's kind of takrim to honor that prophet, to honor that child that will be accused, his mother will be accused. The Jews are going to say everything bad about his mother. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would like to honor him before he's even born, وَرُوحٌ مِنْهُ. There's nothing wrong in the Arabic language to say the Rahullah. Why? When we say the Rasulullah, do you have any problem with that? When you say Abdullah, do you have any problem with that? There's no problem. This is what the Arabic language is. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Rasulina, wa ma ala Rasulina illa al-balagh al-mubin. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala relayed the Prophet to him, what does it mean? It means takrim. That prophet is a special prophet. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said عبدنا أو عبادنا وذكر عبادنا in one ayah, وذكر عبدنا أيوب in different ayah, what does it mean? He is very close to us. He is special to us. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said. So وروح منه is nothing different than عبدنا ورسولنا and all these ayats that has related to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because of the takreem. So we are done with those two couple of words, which is very important. إنما المسيح عيسى ابن رسول الله وكلماته ألقاها إلى مريم وروح منه فآمنوا بالله ورسله. Believe in Allah and His apostles. ولا تقولوا ثلاثة. Don't say three because this is not a fact. This is a false acquisition. This is an invention of human beings who don't know nothing about the truth. انتهوا خيرا لكم. Again, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to all the people in the previous ayah, انتهوا خيرا لكم. And this ayah again, the same thing. انتهوا خيرا لكم. إنما الله إله واحد. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is only one. سبحانه أن يكون له ولد. We glory Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to have a son or a daughter or a wife or a father or a brother. له ما في السماوات وما في الأرض وكفى بالله وكيلا. The rest of the ayats at the end of Surah An-Nisa, inshallah, when you go home, you can read it again. So you can get exactly what the answer of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to those who put Isa in a place that he doesn't even want to be. Because the best he wants to be Abdullah. To be Abdullah, he said it. He said it to his followers. He told them that he is Abdullah. He is nothing but Abdullah. لن يستنكف المسيح أن يكون عبدا لله ولا الملائكة المقربون. الاستنكاف is to be arrogant. To think that you are better than that. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said لن يستنكف المسيح أن يكون عبدا لله. He will never refuse or be arrogant or put himself more than being عبد, a servant to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Neither those very powerful angels. ومن يستنكف عن عبادته ويستكبر فسيحشرهم إليه جميعا. Those who think they are arrogant, then Allah, all of them, they will gather in front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and they will feel that they are nothing when the day of judgment comes, and everybody will be asked about his deed, what he's done, or what he has claimed. There is so many ayahs in the whole Quran about Isa. But I reached my point. Now I would like to go to the topic, so this way I don't take too much time because the topic is very deep and we can talk until tomorrow. But I'll try to make it as condensed as possible, and inshallah we'll take it until we finish the topic every week, one lecture inshallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as we said, when he revealed and the Gospels or the Injil, it was only one Injil. A new Muslim that alhamdulillah Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has helped me to help him to see the light of Islam. He was a scholar. He was doing a PhD in theology. And alhamdulillah, after he became a Muslim, I asked him, you know, how many Bibles do you guys have? He said over 2,000. Over 2,000 Bibles. And each Bible is different. And then I asked him, what do you think? You know, do you all think that? He said, there is no agreement between any of the Christian groups about Jesus, whether he's God or Son of God or partial God, partial human. It's completely a religion that anybody can say anything about it. There is nothing that you can say this is a Christian belief. You can say this is a Muslim belief because we have only one source, we have only one aqidah, we have only, you know, very, very strict teaching about aqidah and the whole Quran and through the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and through the Sahaba. Nothing was left for imagination and the aqidah in Islam, because this is not a topic that you can make a mistake. If you are making a mistake in the aqidah, everything is useless. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will not accept any deeds unless from somebody who knows him and who pray him and who worship him the right way. Anybody who do mistake in the aqidah, all his deeds will be rejected. So one of the ayats, I'm going to start in the ayats from the Bibles. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Isa, was talking to his disciples. I forgot my glasses, so I have to make it very close so I can read it properly. And he was telling them, وهذه هي الحياة الأبدية. I'm reading from the Arabic texture because the copy of the Bible they have in English very, very small, even with the magnifier, I cannot even see it. So I will read it from Arabic texture and I'm going to translate it, inshallah, to the best of my knowledge. وهذه هي الحياة الأبدية أن يعرفوك أنت الإله الحقيقي وحدك ويسوع المسيح الذي أرسلته. أنا مجدتك على الأرض. The translation and this life it is for them to know that you are that this the life that you choose for the believers is the everlasting life. He is talking about the hereafter. The believers in the hereafter, they will have everlasting life. And أن يعرفوك, for them to know you, الإله الحقيقي, the true إله. This is from the Bible. This is not from the Quran. أن يعرفوك الإله الحقيقي وحدك. لأدك الإله الحقيقي وحدك. الإله means there is no other إله. It's only one إله. الحقيقي, the only truthful God. وحدك, only you. ويسوع المسيح, he's talking about himself, the يسوع the Messiah الذي أرسلته, the one that you have sent. So in this ayah, I think it's answer all the questions. إله واحد حقيقي, real, truthful, not imagination. And يسوع الذي أرسلته, عيسى is رسول الله. This عيسى was talking to the disciples about Allah سبحانه وتعالى. Which means you know to the disciple that Allah is real, Allah is واحد, and يسوع that standing in front of you is Rasulullah. This is a copy, a photocopy from the Bible. Okay, this is one evidence. Isa was talking to a lady called Maryam al-Mijdaliya. In the Bible, there's two Maryams being mentioned. We are not talking about his mother. Two Maryams was mentioned. Maryam, a mother of two of the disciples, of Yaqub and his brother. And Maryam al-Mijdaliya, a lady came to Isa. They brought her, the Jews brought Maryam al-Mijdaliya to Isa. And he told, they told him she committed adultery. Go ahead and make the qasas. Put the punishment on her. Isa alayhi salam, he saw that the Jews brought her to test him in a way. So he ignored them. And then he wanted to give them a lesson. He said, any of you who did not commit khati'ah, a sin, go and stone her. So they started to leave one after the other until the end she was by herself. So Isa alayhi salam talked to her about tawbah, about the sin that she committed. And she asked him for forgiveness and to pray for her, and he did. And since that incident, that woman became one of the very close servant, not servant, but mean abudiyah, the very close human beings to Isa alayhi salam. Anywhere she see him, she serve him. So in this incident, when they said that Isa has crucified and he's going to resurrect again, they went to the grave مريم المجدلية and another lady went to the grave where Isa was buried. We are not saying it happened. Where they took the body that they killed to the grave. Let's put it this way. And that she didn't find him. They did not find Isa or anybody in the grave. So while she is returning, she met Isa alayhi salam. And Isa told her, let me see you, don't touch me. Maybe this is part of the tradition that if you touch her, then he cannot talk to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. لا تلمسيني لأني لم أصعد بعد إلى أبي. Don't touch me because I have not met أبي, which is father. We will explain the word أبي later. But we'll say it the way it is now, which means Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. إني لم أصعد بعد, I have not went to my father yet. ولكن اذهبي إلى إخوتي. Go to my brothers. And the question, if he has brothers, then how many God we have? 500? He has so many brothers. All the disciples was his brothers. And the female believers was his sisters. So when he said, إلى إخوتي, it means that he is 100% equal to the people that he sent to. Logically, does it mean anything when he said, yeah, he's my brother? If he's a God, or if he's son of God, would those people be his brothers? It's impossible. It's illogical that he would say, if he is anything but a human being, he will never say, إلى إخوتي. ولكن اذهب إلى إخوتي. This is not the verse what about إخوتي, but the meaning or the main thing is what I'm going to say right now. إني أصعد, I go. إلى أبي وأبيكم, to my father and your father. My father and your father. أبي وأبيكم وإلهي وإلهكم. And my إله and your إله. إني أصعد إلى أبي وأبيكم وإلهي وإلهكم. It's a very short verse. I wish that all our youth can memorize this very half a sentence. إني أصعد إلى أبي وأبيكم وإلهي وإلهكم. So the fatherhood means the love, the one who love. This is in the all the Bible, and I have some ayats that confirm what I'm saying, but let me say it now and then we'll explain it with the ayats later on from the Bible. أبي means beloved, the one that we love the most. أبي وأبيكم, the one I love and the one you love. وإلهي وإلهكم. If you talk to any Christian, they will never mention a verse like that. Because إلهي وإلهكم, my إله and your إله, the game is over. What they're going to argue about if he is saying my إله and your إله, my father and your father. What else? What else can anybody argue? There's nothing to say. It's a very obvious ayah. And from their Bible, that has been so many fallacies, still have a lot of the truth. And in the main thing in the Christianity, which is, who is Jesus? Is he God or the Son of God, or who is he? إلهي وإلهكم. In Sifra Amal al-Rusul, which means the Bible, consists of the following. The four Gospels, Matthew, Luke, and then John, and Mark, Luke, and John. Those are the four main Gospels that the Emperor of Rome has selected, and he burned everything else. Beside that, they have what they called A'mal al-Rusul. Messages, short messages that some of the disciples and some of the followers of Isa has sent to the other towns. Some of them were very sincere, and some of them has caused the Christianity what we have seen today, like Paul. He has very long history about distorting the Christianity. He changed the whole religion. So Mark was one of the very close Hawariyin to Isa. He was the head of the Hawariyin. He has 12 disciples. He was the one who was the closest to Isa, and he was the one in charge of the rest of the Hawariyin. So in that sefer, in that message, he said, he was giving a lecture. أَيُّهَا الرِّجَالُ الْإِسْرَائِلِيُّونَ Oh, the Israelians, the Jews. اسمعوا هذه الأقوال. Listen to these sayings. يسوع الناصري. They called him يسوع الناصري because he was born in نصرة. نصرة is one of the cities or the towns in Palestine. يسوع الناصري رجل إيمان nothing else but إيمان رجل قد تبرهن لكم it was proven to you من قبل الله it was proven to you that he is from the side of God he is not false Messiah he is not false prophet he is not anything but a prophet a رجل was proven to you from the side of Allah subhanahu من قبل الله بقوات الله and with the power of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala وعجائب وآيات عجائب means wonderful things things which is doesn't touch your mind like creating you know some of the dead or bringing reviving the some of the dead and making the birds from clay and he whisper or he blow on it and it be a real tire وآيات صنعها الله بيده آيات which means signs صنعها الله بيده Allah made it on his hand Allah made it on his hand the same exact ayah that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in Surah Al-Ma'idah أن أخلق له من الطير من الطين كهنأة الطير that I created just as was talking I created a bird from the clay and I blow on it فيكون طيرا it will be a bird with the power of Allah فيكون طورا طيرا بإذن الله وإبرئ الأكمه والأبرص وأحيي الموتى بإذن الله and I can cause cure to their the sick people and I can bring the sight back to those who are blind بإذن الله by the power of Allah سبحانه وتعالى وأنبئكم بما تأكلون وما تدخرون في بيوتكم إن في ذلك لآية لكم إن كنتم مؤمنين. So the same ayah is exactly what is translated here before the Quran was revealed. يسوع النصري رجل قد تبرهن لكم من قبل الله بقوة الله وعجائب وآيات صنعها الله بيده في وسطكم in the middle of your presence. All this ayat has been happening in front of you while you are present, not behind your back. كما أنتم تعلمون as you all know. Another ayah, we're going to keep, it's all ayat about the oneness of Allah, that Al-Masih Abdullah, في ذلك الوقت أجاب يسوع وقال It was a time, a hard time and they got so tired and then المسيح said and he said those words At that time أجاب يسوع يسوع answered and he said أحمدك أيها الرب I thank you the Lord رب السماء والأرض رب السماء والأرض أحمدك أيها الأب رب السماء والأرض I thank you Allah the Lord رب السماء والأرض the Lord of whatever above us whatever underneath us لأنك أخفيت هذه عن الحكماء والفقهاء وعلنتها للأطفال نعم أيها الأب amazing You know, I can't believe anybody who has a heart, who read the Bible, and claim that Jesus is anything but Abdullah wa Rasuluh. I cannot imagine, unless he has some other games. And this is what I think it is. It's a game of money and power. It's a game of, you know, the Christians are not allowed to read the Bible. They are not allowed to read the Bible. They have to listen just to the priest. Or this is why the Bob to them is like Allah. He can make things halal or haram. He can choose whatever he wants. He can change the whole thing to them. Because divorce, we know that it's forbidden in the Christian. All the Bibles, they said that divorce is not allowed. The Bob said, no, it's okay, because it's a necessity. He changed the religion. He changed the Bible himself. This is what the Christianity is. When Uday ibn Hatim al-Ta'i, the very well-known Sahabi, he was an example of the karam, of the generosity. He came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. When he came to accept Islam, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam respected him because he is Sharif in his tribe. He is the head of his tribe. And his father is known in Arabia before Islam about generosity. People talk about Hatim al-Ta'i. And his son is Uday, the Sahabi. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was reading the ayah, reciting the ayah. اتخذوا أحبارهم ورهبانهم أربابا من دون الله والمسيح ابن مريم. They took their priests and high priests أرباب beside Allah. And Uday ibn Hatim said, ما اتخذناهم آلهة. We did not do that. We haven't taken them as آلهة. O Prophet of Allah. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم asked him, ألم يحل لكم الحلال ويحرموا عليكم الحلال؟ ألم يحل لكم الحرام ويحرموا عليكم الحلال؟ Haven't they made things حرام to be halal and things halal to be haram? He said yes. And the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم فتلك عبادتكم إياهم. This is an act of worship. This is the عبادة. Because عبودية is to obey Allah سبحانه وتعالى in every حكم. When somebody, a human being, share the hakimiyah with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he associates with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When any of the emir or president or anybody say, what are these rules of Quran in this or that? Let's make different rules. This is shirk, immediately. So, this is an ayah, the other ayah, أحمدك أيها الأب رب السماء والأرض. There is no difference between this and the teaching of the Quran. It is all came from the same source. It can't be disputed. The fact that Isa is Rasulullah. Another evidence, another ayah, that one young man, he came to Isa alayhi salam, and he was calling him when he was coming, أيها المعلم الصالح, O the righteous معلم, teacher. Isa عليه السلام, he immediately stopped him. لماذا تدعوني صالحا? Why you are calling me righteous? لماذا تدعوني صالحا? ليس أحد صالحا إلا واحد هو الله. There is nobody صالح, righteous, except واحد, only one, Allah سبحانه وتعالى. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This ayat is, you know, from the Coptic copy of the Bible, which this is what in their Bible, but they are the most fanatic people in the earth defending the uluhiyya of Isa, that Isa is a Lord. Wal'azu billah. Okay. One more. لا تدعوا لكم أبا على الأرض لأن أباكم واحد الذي في السماوات ولا تدعوا معلمين لأن معلمكم واحد هو المسيح. He's teaching his disciples. لا تدعوا لكم أبا. Don't call yourself a father. لأن أباكم واحد الذي في السماء. Because you have only one father, the one in the heaven. Now we can understand the word father means. The beloved Lord, the beloved Ilah. This is what it means. It has nothing to do with you know, physical fatherhood or sonshood or anything like that. Because he is talking to his disciples, telling them, لا تدعوا لكم أبا على الأرض. Don't call a father on earth. لأن أباكم واحد الذي في السماء. أباكم. Not my father. أباكم. Your father. He's talking to the disciples. Your fathers. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the father of everything. It is a word that was known at that time as beloved. Even in our religion, in Islam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَجَبَتْ مُحَبَّتِي لِلْمُتَحَبِّينَ فِي وَجَبَتْ مُحَبَّتِي لِلْمُتَزَاوِرِينَ فِي الْمُتَزَاوِرِينَ فِي عَلَى مَنَابِرٍ مِنْ نُورٍ وَجَبَتْ مُحَبَّتِي My love is due to those who sit together for my cause or visit each other for my cause. What's mahabba means? Does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, subhanahu wa ta'ala, is a lover to any of us? No. Mahabba min Allah, from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, means acceptance. Al-rida. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pleased of what you do. When you do some act that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loves you to do, this what means. Wajabat mahabbati. رضي الله عنهم ورضوا عنه in the ayat. What rida means? Acceptance. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has accepted those. So there is no physical meaning when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that وجب محبتي. قل إن كنتم تحبون الله فاتبعوني يحببكم الله. Allah will love you. What does mean of love in here? Love. Acceptance. Allah will accept you. This is what mean. They trusted everything to a physical meaning where they have hundreds of evidence that the physical meaning doesn't fit in any word in the Bible. Nothing in the Bible can invite anybody to believe that there is a physical fatherhood between Isa and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Hasha lillah. Nothing. And inshallah, I don't know if we can finish everything in 3-4 lectures, but we will continue with the topic. We are going to answer their claims that they took some verses of the Bible and then they interpreted their way. And we're going to answer that inshallah when the time comes. So, just an idea about what all this, what the distortion, what the Christianity happened like that. Before Christianity, hundreds of prophets, none of them claimed that he's the Son of God or the Trinity, that God is three. Why it happened to the Christianity? There is some reasons. It is not a justified reason, but there is some reasons. Okay? It doesn't mean they are right because they have reasons. No. But we are talking, you know, scientifically, there is some reasons that the people wanted that way. One of those reasons, as we said in the beginning, the distance between Isa and Musa. 1500 years is a lot of time to the people to forget and change and even invent new religions. 1500 years is a lot of time. And also, as we said, in the time, in the first 3 centuries of the Christianity, there was so much pressure in anybody who said that he a follower of Isa. There is too much pressure that anybody who can have a copy of the Bible of Isa will be killed. The Romans started to kill any Christian, any follower of Jesus, any true Muslim at that time, they will be killed. People started to hide their religion. They started to hide their books. And when things are dark, the light cannot be seen. Because how can you learn if you cannot have a source of learning? Where everything is secret, who's going to teach you? If a teacher sit with his a student like that, he would be killed. People started to hide their identity because of the aggression of the Roman Empire. A lot of the atheists, the kafirs, the philosophers at that time, they came to the Christianity. But they came with their own old beliefs. They still have a lot of jahiliyyah, in them. So when they came to the Christianity, there is no teachers, there is no disciples, nobody to show them what's right or wrong. So they took part and then they mixed it with what they have, and this is what the religion is. This is the best they can get, because it was a very rough time for everybody. So the philosophers and the Roman who came into Christianity at this time, they came with a lot of, you know, inventory from the old kufr. So when they came to a Christianity, they don't have full exposure to what the Christianity is. So this is one reason, and this is why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he watched everything that the Sahaba is doing. Make sure that nothing of jahiliyyah will be in their heart. Khalid ibn al-Walid, he used to love a tree before he became a Muslim. A tree that he think bring a blessing. What did the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did? He told him to go and cut it off. He didn't ask anybody else. Let that guy go and cut it off so you to destroy the element of jahiliyyah that might be that might have in his mind. When one of the Sahabi called Bilal ibn al-Sawda, when one of the Sahabi called Bilal, your mother is black, or as we say nowadays, when you call somebody nigger, it is not a good word. It's even an illegal word. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said him, when he heard that, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was so angry at him. And for that Sahabi to make it up to Bilal, he went and he put his cheek on the floor. He told Bilal, step on my face. Step on my face so you can get your right. Because what he did, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told him, إِنَّكَ مْرِئٌ فِيكَ جَاهِلِيَّةٌ. When he heard, you are a man that has little bit of jahiliyyah. You still have something that's not be said. Because in Islam, we don't call you are a son of that, or we don't put each other down or each other up because of family history or education or position or financial, you know, ability or disability. No, this has nothing to do with Islam. This is jahiliyyah. Also, Polis, which is Paul, he distorted this religion. He distorted the religion in all his teaching, talk about the Uluhiyyah of Isa. He was a Jew, and then he converted to Christianity. He used to cause a lot of harm to Jesus, and all of a sudden he saw a dream and he became Christian, but he is responsible to most of the distortion that happened to the Christianity. And we will prove that inshallah and time to come. The emperor himself, he was an atheist and he was sick, and he accepted Christianity few days before he died. He's the one who made that simply got all the Bibles, and he gathered all the priests all over the world and let them debate. But for some reason, he didn't like the opinion of the majority who are muwahideen. And inshallah, next lecture inshallah is going to be about the muwahideen in the early time of Christianity. He didn't like their lecture. He said, okay, burn all these books, get all those people out, let's just take the Trinity. And let's just keep those Bibles and burn everything else. It is just a political order. And the people, they just listened and went for the rest of the history that Trinity is the Christianity. And also the assemblies that happened in the history of Christianity, most of those assemblies was from the side of the emperor who just want to keep the Trinity and the Uluhiyyah of Isa as the religion of the Christian Empire. I'm not even half done, so it's up to you if I'd like to continue or I can quit and continue later on. Another ayat. Ya Allah. about Isa, when he spoke about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, look what he said. ولكن لكي تعلموا, so for you to know, أن ابن الإنسان, ابن الإنسان, when Isa was, talk about himself as a human being, he always say ابن الإنسان, the man, the son of the mankind. When he would like to reveal something, he say, my father, because that revelation or that teaching is coming from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But if he would like to suggest something from his own, he call himself ابن الإنسان. So many ayats in the Bible about that, ابن الإنسان.